Presidential spokesperson Harry Roque on Tuesday, January 12, says Filipinos living in certain provinces may miss out on the Pfizer-BioNTech vaccine because of lack of ultra-cold storage facilities.
Pero hindi naman po lahat yan ay pwedeng piliin ng ating mga kababayan dahil yung Pfizer po kinakailangan ng negative 70. No? Ibig sabihin po, para lang yan sa Maynila, Cebu, Davao na mayroong mga cold storage facilities.
Out of all vaccine brands, the Pfizer-BioNTech vaccine has the highest efficacy of 95% against COVID-19. On Monday, January 11, Philippine vaccine czar Carlito Galvez Jr. tells senators the rollout of COVID-19 vaccines to the public may begin as soon as February 2021. He adds vaccination can start more or less in the third to fourth week next month. The doses expected to arrive on February 20 will come from Gavi's COVAX facility. The government is also expecting a delivery of the vaccine developed by Chinese firm Sinovac next month. Its vaccine, CoronaVac, does not require ultra-cold storage. During the Senate hearing, senators urged the Duterte government to allow local governments and private groups to secure their own vaccine deals. Senate President Pro Tempore Ralph Recto describes the involvement of the national government as a bottleneck in ensuring Filipinos' timely access to the vaccines. Senate Minority Leader Franklin Drilon also echoes Recto's sentiments, saying the process seems like a stumbling block in buying COVID-19 vaccines. But Galvez says no company would engage in deals not involving national governments of countries. In related news, Malacanang on Tuesday, January 12, announces a ban on the entry of all non-Filipino travelers coming from China. This comes nearly 2 weeks after the Asian giant detected its first case of the new COVID-19 virus variant. Apart from China, the same restrictions were announced for Jamaica, Luxembourg, Oman, and Pakistan. The Philippine government excludes the Commission on Human Rights, or CHR, in the initial interagency panel that would investigate the killings during Duterte's war on drugs. This statement comes as Justice Secretary Menardo Guevara announces the initial report of the panel has been submitted to the Office of the President. CHR Commissioner Karen Gomez-Dumpit says they regret the CHR was not involved in the review, contrary to the commitments and assurances made by the government. Guevara previously announced the creation of the review panel in June 2020, assuring the United Nations that the CHR will be involved as an independent monitoring body. Dumpit says the Commission's exclusion is an unfulfilled promise to Filipinos and the entire community of nations. In December 2020, International Criminal Court prosecutor Fatou Bensouda said there is reasonable basis to believe that crimes against humanity were committed in the drug war. President Rodrigo Duterte taps former Justice Secretary Vitaliano Aguirre II to be Commissioner of the National Police Commission, or Napolcom. Napolcom is in charge of disciplining police personnel and investigating irregularities in the police force. Presidential spokesperson Harry Roque on Monday, January 11, says it was Duterte who asked Aguirre to join Napolcom to represent the private sector. This comes after the death of Napolcom Vice Chairman and Executive Officer Rogelio Casorao last January 2. To fill in his post, Interior Secretary Eduardo Año, his also Napolcom chairperson, had appointed Felizardo Serapio Jr. as officer in charge. During his time as Justice Secretary, Aguirre was hounded by controversies in the Justice Department. This includes the dismissal of DOJ prosecutors of charges against self-confessed drug lord Kerwin Espinosa and Peter Lim. Congressional Democrats begin a push to force United States President Donald Trump from office. They introduce on Monday, January 11, one article of impeachment accusing him of inciting insurrection over the violent attack on the Capitol. The Democratic-led House of Representatives plans to vote as soon as Wednesday on formal charges of misconduct known as articles of impeachment. This unless Trump resigns or Vice President Mike Pence moves to oust him under a provision in the U.S. Constitution. The House is also set to vote on Tuesday on a resolution calling on Pence to invoke the 25th Amendment within a day. It is a never-before-used law allowing a majority of the cabinet to strip the president of power if he or she is unable to carry out official duties. Pence's advisor says he is opposed to the idea, but House Speaker and top Democrat legislator Nancy Pelosi says Trump's threat to America is urgent and so too will be the lawmaker's action. The violence at the Capitol reportedly caused a serious rift between Trump and Pence. Meantime, Republican Congressional Leader Kevin McCarthy says Trump acknowledged he bears some responsibility for the Capitol attack. Trump adds he feels bad about what happened. McCarthy shares details of a phone call where he told the outgoing president to, quote, call President-elect Joe Biden for the sake of the nation. Authorities are reinforcing security ahead of Biden's inauguration in January 20. The ceremony was dramatically scaled back due to the coronavirus pandemic. The FBI also warns of armed protests planned for Washington and all 50 capitals even before the 20th. Several Facebook posts from the verified account of Loren Badoy claim red tagging is a term invented by the Communist Party of the Philippines, the New People's Army, and the National Democratic Front. These are false. The term was not invented by the CPP-NPA-NDF. It was used even before the CPP was founded. Loren Badoy is an undersecretary of the Presidential Communications Operations Office and the spokesperson of the National Task Force to End Local Communist Armed Conflict. Badoy made the claim in a Facebook post as early as October 18, 2020. Since then, Badoy repeated the false claim at least four more times in her posts from October 2020 to January 2021. In December, she also claimed the term only exists in the Philippines, but the terms red tagging, red tag, or red tagged, used in contexts involving communism, were already in use in foreign printed material before CSUN founded the CPP. This is also contrary to Badoy claiming red tagging only exists in the Philippines. A document printed in 1947 about U.S. Congress hearings on the supposed communist infiltration in the motion picture industry contained the word. American newspaper Pittsburgh Press also published a report in 1955 that contained the word red tagged. As of Tuesday, January 12, Badoy's Facebook account is unavailable on the platform.